JaVale got to start with that three-pointer. You got the ball above the arc. You kind of waited, and you let it fly. What was that like?
I got the ball above the arc. I kind of waited. I let it fly.
Going to see more of that?
If that situation happens again, yeah, for sure.
Now, Frank kind of joked. He's been helping you with your three-point touch. Is that true?
If it needs to be true, yeah.
Okay. And take like two or three a game, maybe?
Hey. However many are allotted to me.
All right. How about the AD news? He's day-to-day. Is that a relief for you?
Yeah, definitely. He's obviously a major part in this organization and how we need to play. So day-to-day is way better than anything else.
You talked last year a little bit about extending your range and using it, but you didn't really get a chance to do it very much in games.
Mm-hmm.
What's the sort of the comfort level between even just last year and this year in taking that?
I mean, I've always been comfortable shooting threes. I shot threes in college, so I just never was able to. So I never was allowed to. So
you think there'll be more opportunity this year? Do you think? Or
no, I don't think it'll be more opportunity. No.
Hey, JaVale, how do you think for you the turnaround from a preseason trip in China 2 years ago in Golden State compared to this time around?
What do you mean the turnaround? Like, what
is with just getting back. And dealing with the jet lag and playing.
I don't think last year we had a game like right the day after we came back from China when I was with the Warriors. So that's the difference.
How about the experience overall this time around versus when you went with the Warriors? Anything that was felt so
I was with a different team. That's about it.
You and Dwight both at center. It appears if you guys lose. Nothing to both you guys in the game. How can that be a benefit for the team having both you guys?
48 minutes of a rolling five, and being able to keep Eddie at the four, which he wants. So that's definitely a plus.
JaVale, a lot of uncertainty when you guys were in China. A lot of canceled plans, and at one point it looked like the games might be canceled. How did you kind of deal with that while you guys were over there?
I dealt with it. What else choice did I have? I couldn't leave. Yeah, I dealt with it.
What are some of the ways that you've noticed in playing with Anthony that he makes things easier for the team when he's out on the court?
When he has the ball, of course, eyes are on him. So that makes it easier for the off-ball guys to get the open spots, to find spaces on the floor, to find it open, and he can pass the ball. So it's definitely he's a dangerous player. On offense and defense, but on offense, everybody's looking at him, so it frees up everybody else, I feel like, especially having him and Bron.
You've always had a really unique athleticism, and so does he as well. How do you picture that meshing in terms of what
I think it meshes very well, especially on the rebounding end and on the defensive shot blocking end, because if he's not blocking the shot, I'm blocking the shot, or if I'm going for the block and I don't get it, he's going to go get the rebound at least while I contested it, so it's definitely a plus.
Frank talked a little bit about how they don't have to change much when you're on the floor versus Dwight.
Mm-hmm.
Where are the places that you think your skill sets are a little bit different that might help, with different matchups or things he does that you don't do as well and vice versa?
I don't know what things that he does that I don't do as well. The only thing I think I like do very well is knowing how to stay out the way and get buckets without having calls, having plays called for me. Like I can go get an offensive rebound, I'll go set a screen roll, I'll find a way, offensive tip, I'll find a way without ever getting post-up calls.
Thanks. Thanks, you guys.